All right, so we've talked about how to get a faster hospital in 5 days using the simple tools of Lean, some post-it notes, the little 5S to simplify and streamline. And when you do that, Lean also reduces mistakes. But the mistakes that remain, we're going to use Six Sigma. So let's look at how to get a better hospital in 5 days. Now, one of the rules out there, most of the data I've seen in healthcare is about a 1% error rate. And it doesn't matter what the error rate is, whether it's infections or complications or falls or, all these things are at least 1% error. And so that puts us at about 3% error. So what we want to do is find ways to actually move this and take it down from 3 defects to something a little bit closer to 3 parts per million. So Six Sigma is really, we used to look at things in a percentage way, so a 1% error rate didn't sound bad until you go, well, that's 10,000 patients per million. And so what we want to do in our patients per million is drive that as low as possible. And that'll also significantly increase our ability to provide for our patients and make money and all that kind of stuff. So here's how I think about it. Every hospital is a factory. Now, you may have patients going through your clinical part, but you have marketing and sales and orders and invoicing, purchasing and payments, and there's a lot of things that can go wrong in these other areas, not just the clinical part. So we have clinical problems and we have operational problems that we can solve with Six Sigma. Now, here you can see that there's what I call a fix-it factory. And so you can't hardly see it. You can't tell if the patient in a bed is, had a some sort of mistake which led to a situation where you're not getting paid for them, and so you can't tell if you're just taking care of them and it's a fix-it factory situation. And your patients and your payers, they're also part of your fix-it factory. So if a problem occurs in the hospital and the patients have to take care of a relative or something like that, the fix-it costs are estimated in healthcare to be at least $1 trillion, and that's just on your side of the fence, not on your patient's side of the fence or the payers. So what we want to do is find ways to simplify and streamline all that. So here's the deal. Defects, let me make sure I'm in the right place here. Defects, I use what I call the 450 rule. Now the 450 rule is a modification, an extension of the 80-20 rule. It said 20% of what you do produces 80% of your mistakes and errors and defects and mortality and all that kind of stuff. And within that, though, Pareto's rule is actually a power law. And here you can see that 4% of what you do, that's one step out of every 25, produces over half of the mistakes and waste and rework and errors and infections and blah, 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 blah. So what we want to do is find a way to focus and narrow our focus down to that 4%. And if you want to increase your returns, you want to narrow your focus. I know most people are trying to teach you that, gee, you ought to open up Six Sigma and you ought to spread it wall to wall, floor to ceiling throughout there. Nonsense, all right? What we want to do is narrow our focus and put it on key things. So to increase your returns, narrow your focus. And you notice if we dramatically reduce this first bar, we're going to get a 50-60% return on investment. So here's how I think about Six Sigma tools. Six Sigma on all the training, the green belts and the black belts, that's all designed for people who actually work on a manufacturing floor. It's not designed for healthcare. All right, so all of the tools, I call them the long tools, long tail of the tools out here, you don't really need to know. A handful of tool will take care of 90% of the problems facing healthcare. And those tools are simple. Post-it notes and Lean, a control chart, a Pareto chart, a fishbone diagram will solve most of the problems that you're experiencing. So I grew up kind of in between the old PDCA methodology and the DMAIC or DMAIC methodology of Six Sigma, and I had my own acronym called Focus, then Improve, then Sustain, and then Honor Your Progress. So the first piece is to really focus your improvement efforts in ways that are going to give you breakthrough improvements in speed and quality. Not little diddly incremental ones, all right? We can't have 4-hour wait times and elapsed times in emergency departments. We got to get that under an hour or less. And so what we want to do here is find ways to significantly improve that. And so this is often the step called define and measure. Now I've found most hospitals have way too much data they're already measuring, so there's no reason to go out and invent some new measure, right? We're going to use a control chart to show our performance over time. And it doesn't matter if it's clinical errors, pharmacy errors, radiological repeats, anything that's going on here, financial costs, denied claims, anything that's out here, we can put into a control chart. And then we're going to take all of that and we're going to figure out, you know, what are the buckets? How we're going to use Pareto charts to figure out what's the big bar here and narrow our focus. And then we can use the fishbone diagram and asking why to come up with the root cause, come up with some countermeasures, and implement them. And most of the time, it's not $1 million cost to go buy stuff, right, or build on a new wing. And when we change how things work and the process works, we mistake-proof things, and all of a sudden, you start saving a ton of time and money.